Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about houses. A house provides a sense of security and well-being. It protects us from extreme weather conditions and provides shelter. People live in different kind of houses. Some live in temporary houses while others live in permanent houses. So children, the name of the chapter which we are going to study today is Houses We Live In. In this chapter, we will understand why we need to live in a house, different types of houses, materials which are used in making houses. So let's start the chapter. All of us need a house to live in. A house protects us from harsh weather like heat, cold, rain, thunderstorm, etc. It protects us from wild animals. It also protects us from thieves and dacoits. We find different type of houses at different places. The type of a house depends on two factors. They are locally available materials and climatic condition of that place. So these are two important factors based on which we will find houses in any particular area. Generally, houses are of two types, pakka house and kaccha house. Now, what are pakka houses? Pakka houses are strong houses. They are made of wood, bricks, cement, iron rods and steel. Flats and bungalows are pakka houses. Such houses are called permanent houses. So, they are permanent, they cannot be broken easily. Next is kaccha houses. Kaccha houses are made of wood, mud, straw and dry leaves. A hut is a kaccha house. People in villages generally live in kaccha houses. These houses are temporary houses. Now some people live at one place for a very short time. They build different types of houses that can be moved from one place to another place. Now such people live in, the first one you can see, caravan. Gypsies live in houses on wheels called caravans. These can be moved from one place to another easily. Now who are gypsies? Gypsies are basically nomad people who don't stay at one place for a very long time. They keep on moving. Our next topic is tent. Some people live at one place for a very short time. They live in tents. A makeshift house. A house made of canvas is a tent. Many soldiers live in tents in their camp. Campers also use it. So this canvas material is used for making houses which are called as tent. Our next topic is houseboat. A houseboat is a floating house made up of wood. In Kashmir, many people live in houseboats. In Kashmir, there is a famous lake which is called as Dal Lake, and this Dal Lake is full of beautifully decorated houseboats. Next is igloo. A house made of snow or ice blocks is called an igloo. Eskimos live in igloos in Iceland. It keeps them warm. Such igloos are generally found in Arctic and polar regions which are completely covered with snow and are extremely cold. The picture you can see on the right hand side, this is an igloo. And the people who live in such areas or such regions, they are called as Eskimos. Our next topic is tilt house. These kind of houses are found where it rains heavily and water is locked always. People of such areas make wooden houses on stilts with bamboos. These houses are often found in Assam, Arunachal Pradesh. So children, you can see in the image on the left hand side, this is a stilt house which is raised above the ground on poles, or you can say bamboo logs. Now children, let's see what factor is given in this did you know box. An igloo made with packs of ice is a temporary house. So children, it is a temporary house. It is not a permanent house. Long ago, most people lived in these ice igloos. Now children, let's move on to our next topic. materials needed to build a house. There are certain materials which are required to make a house. So let's study about that. Houses in the city are made up of bricks, cement and steel. Wood and glass are used to make doors and windows. Houses in villages are made up of straw, wood, mud and stones. These days, some villages also have pakka houses. Different roofs of houses. Houses on hills have sloping roofs. People living in areas where it rains a lot make houses on stilts with sloping roofs. People living in plains usually make houses with flat roofs. Now children, houses on hills have sloping roofs. It is because the snow which falls on the roof, it shouldn't stay on the roof. Because generally, hilly areas, the houses are made up of wood. If this ice or snow will remain on the roof, it will spoil the wood. So that is why they have sloping roof. Our next topic is, how can we define a good house? A good house should have plenty of fresh air and sunshine. A good house should have trees nearby. A good house should be neat and clean. A good house should have a proper drainage system. So whatever water is used in the kitchen and in the washrooms, they should be properly removed out. They should not block the sewage system. The next is, observe the types of houses in your locality and try to find out about the materials used to build them. So this is the activity which you have to do by yourself. You have to find out the materials which are used in making the houses which are there in your locality. Now let's see what is given here in the did you know box. A skyscraper is a tall building with multiple floors. So it is a huge building. There are 10 million bricks in the Empire State Building in the New York. So this building is a skyscraper. Next is try this. List a few skyscrapers and paste their pictures in your scrapbook. So children, these activity you have to do all by yourself. All the best to all of you.